Manu, good morning.
Hello.
You too. Hi. Welcome. I think when people hear the sound of the hang, a lot of people sort of associate it with spirituality or nature. But the hang fits in much more styles probably than we know. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I think because it's so new and young, it's not traditionally linked to a certain place. Like back in the days when something was invented, it grew locally and spread out from there and spread through the word of mouth or whatever.
Yes.
Now in the 21st century, if you invent something, it goes online and it's a global phenomenon. And so, I mean, some people associate it with the Caribbeans or Asia or something, but it's not really linked. And I'm trying to use it in as many different contexts as possible. So I work with classical musicians, with orchestras and choirs. I work with DJs and electronic music producers, pop and jazz artists. So lots of different stuff. And I think it's a real, for me, this was a real sort of opening of opportunities with this instrument because it's so free in a way. It was also, it pushed me as a composer as well because there was no music written for it. So I had to come up with my own music. So first I started improvising and writing solo pieces. Then added a few musicians and it got sort of bigger and bigger and then started adding electronics like in a piece I just played. So yeah, it's a really interesting journey and almost like learning a new language.
Yes. Tell us a bit about the instrument so we can understand more about you combining it in other styles also. What are we looking at exactly?
So these are different hangs or sometimes also called handpan. This is sort of the family of instruments. And each of them has eight different notes. Sometimes that's more or less, but in my case it's eight. And these are these little dents. And the bigger the dent, the lower the note. And then there's also a bass note on the top. And I'm using three of those because they have different pitches. So with the three, I basically have a chromatic scale, which means I've got all the 12 different notes of the Western tonal system available.
And what is the hard part of it?
Well, it's not as logical as, for example, a piano where you have the low notes on the left and the high notes on the right, you know, where it's like it sort of goes up in steps. Here, the notes are all over the place and it takes some time to sort of know where things are. And well, it's like a tuned percussion instrument, I'd say. So you tune with, you deal with
whatever
the usual. I've played a lot of marimba, for example, and in a way there are a lot of similarities, what you can do and what you can't do. But then what's really nice about it is that you have the whole percussive side of it really close, so you can play pitched sounds, but like 2 centimeters further right, it's like it gets really percussive. So it's in between a melodic and a percussive instrument, I'd say.
Very nice. Would you say that the hang fits or sounds best when it's being played solo or accompanying? Does it stay alive in a lot of when there's massive sound?
Well, it's in the nature. In nature, it's a quiet instrument, so it's not ideal if I'm on a loud stage where there's a lot of other stuff. So then, that's not really ideal for this instrument. But again, this is the same for any quiet instrument. It's a very resonant instrument, so playing solo is something I like, but I don't really like playing solo for a whole like 90-minute show, so I prefer interacting with other musicians and I like how other instruments can change the role of what I do, especially bass instruments. I can stay, do the same thing over and over again. If the bass changes, that sort of totally changes how my melody or pattern, whatever, sounds in the context. So I do like playing with other musicians, but in a way,
like Björk,
for example.
How did that come about? How did she find you?
She saw me on YouTube quite a long time ago, like 8 years ago or something. Then she got in touch and we recorded for her album Biophilia together, and then ever since I've been on tour.
On tour with her, amazing. What were you playing before? Because obviously, this is from 2000. Before you were playing something. You were studying at the Mozarteum.
Yeah, I played mainly drums. I mean, I've tried out all sorts of instruments as a child, and I'm glad I did. I've tried accordion and guitar and piano. Mm-hmm. But mainly I played the drums and different percussion.
And where did you found the hang?
My father saw it at the festival in 2003, I think, and then he showed it to me online. It was only a photo and a sound sample then. It was no video, so mm-hmm. that was before YouTube. YouTube mm-hmm. didn't exist then.
Wow.
And so we ordered one, and it came in a box and opened it, and then I basically had to figure out how to play it.
Wow. Okay, the last question, because I bet you have a lot of future plans for your music and the hang. You did an interesting project in the Alps. Tell me briefly about that.
Yeah, that's brand new. We recorded a film last year in the autumn, and it will be released in September mm-hmm. this year. And it's basically a 1 week long hike that I did with seven musicians, and along this hike we recorded a film and an album, which is under quite extreme circumstances. So we were not only walking, it was actually climbing and glacier hiking, and so it was a physical challenge and a musical challenge, and I think we got away with a very interesting product, which is mainly a 30 minutes music and mountain film.
And what is the name of it?
It's called Parasol Peak.
Parasol Peak. Okay, it will be released in
7th of September this year.
Okay, so we have something to look forward to. Thank you so much for being here and for introducing The Hang.
Thank you.
We're going to listen to you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.